Hello everyone, Sobroni of GNA Reviews here with an event guide for the upcoming Guda Guda Meiji Isshin event. This is going to be an in-depth guide covering everything from the newest servants to in-depth farming strategy. So to make it easier, I have timestamps in the description so you can jump ahead to whatever part of the video you need to reference. Also, I just want to note that in order to participate in this event, you must have cleared Fuyuki, which is the first chapter of the story. Once you've done that, you'll be able to fully participate in this event. So without further ado, let's talk about the new servants we're going to be getting. With this new event, we're getting two brand new servants. One of them is going to be the welfare servant you can get for free just by completing the event, and the other one is going to be a limited servant in the gacha. First up, let's talk about the welfare, Cha-Cha. Cha-Cha is a 4-star berserker with 8,945 attack and 11,025 HP. She's an AoE berserker that is especially good for farming. I actually have a full spotlight for her. It'll be linked in the description below, so if you want to know more about her and how to use her effectively, make sure you check out that spotlight. Moving on to the limited servant, we have Hijikata Toshizo. He is also a berserker, but a 5-star. He has a max attack of 12,089 and a max HP of 12,028. He is a single target Buster Noble Phantasm and is a powerful berserker. I also have a spotlight on him linked in the description so you can find out more. On top of those two new servants, we also have rate-ups for Nikola Tesla, Thomas Edison, and Helena. All three of them have spotlights linked in the description below, so check those out if you're curious about rolling for them. But for now, let's move on to talking about the event craft essences. This event, just like all the other events, is going to introduce a plethora of new craft essences. We're going to have a lot of new gacha craft essences, but also two new craft essences that are available in the event itself. Let's talk about the gacha ones first. First up, we have Flower of High Society. This is a 3-star craft essence that increases quick and arch card effectiveness by 4% and also increases the drops of the bronze coins by 1. If you limit break it, it's going to increase quick and arch card effectiveness by 2 and increase drops by 2. This is actually a fairly decent budget craft essence for arts quick servants like Kuro, Dyrmud, and Fion, even outside of this event. Next up, we have the 4-star Springwind Promenade. This is going to increase NP gain by 15% and apply damage cut 300, as well as increase gold dust drops by 1 for this event. If you limit break it, it's going to increase NP gain by 20%, apply damage cut 400, and increase gold dust drops by 2. And this is also a very good craft essence outside the event. It's great for defensive NP spammers like Mosh, Waver, and George. And finally, the last gacha craft essence is Demon King of the Sixth Heaven. It is a 5-star craft essence that increases Buster card effectiveness by 15% and NP strength by 15%. It also increases Koban drops by 1, and if you limit break it, it's going to increase Buster card effectiveness and NP strength by 20% and the drops by 2. This is an absolute beast of a craft essence for any Buster servant with a powerful Noble Phantasm. It's great on servants like Berserkers, Nobu, Gil, Rama, any strong Buster servant is going to greatly appreciate this craft essence. Now let's take a look at the event craft essence. First up, let's talk about the event shop craft essence, and that is Castle of the Sun. It's a 5-star craft essence that increases critical strength and critical starter drop rate by 15% and NP gauge by 25% at the start of the battle. For this event, it's also going to increase your points by 30%, both Oda and Shinsengumi. And if you limit break that, it's going to increase your crit strength and critical star drop rate by 20%, start you off with 40% NP charge, and increase your points drops by 60%. This is one of the best crit craft essences in the game. It goes perfectly with Jack, Okita, Nobunaga, Emiya, and any other star generating crit servant. And finally, we have Wolves of Mibu. This is a 5-star craft essence that you can get from the point ladder. It increases your quick and buster card effectiveness by 8% and grants you 3 crit stars per turn. For this event, it's also going to increase the attack of all allies by 50%. If you limit break it, it's going to increase your quick and buster card effectiveness by 10%, grant you 4 crit stars per turn, and increase the attack strength of all allies by 100%. This is a strong craft essence on quick and buster servants, and it's tailor-made for servants like Okita and Artoria Lancer Alter. The event shop for this event isn't anything unique. Just like every other event shop, there's 3 different currencies. You have your Koban, which is the gold currency, gold dust, which is the silver currency, and bronze coins, which are the bronze currency. The bronze coins can get you a copy of Castle of the Sun, as well as Cerebral Spinal Fluid, Chain of Fools, 4-star and 3-star Experience, and 3-star Foes. While the Gold Dust will allow you to buy 2 copies of Castle of the Sun, Spirit Root, Ghost Lantern, Heroes Proof, and Saber, Archer, and Berserker pieces. And finally, the Gold Kobans will allow you to buy 2 more copies of Castle of the Sun, Scarab of Wisdom, Lamps, Great Knight Medals, and Saber, Archer, and Berserker Monuments. If you plan on buying out the entire shop, you're going to need 2,800 bronze coins, 2,850 gold dust, and 3,000 koban. There are 3 things to note about the shop. The first thing is that there are 5 craft essences available, so you can actually buy all the craft essences you need to max limit break Castle of the Sun. You don't need to farm craft essence drops from this event. The second thing to note is there's also going to be an additional item for purchase in the shop, which is going to be extra copies of Cha-Cha, which are going to be purchasable with the fan item. The fan item is not something you farm, it's a reward for reaching certain milestones in the point ladder, and Cha-Cha does not appear as available for purchase until all the main quests are finished, so you aren't able to buy her right away. The unique feature of this event is going to be the point ladder. This is exactly the same as the previous Guda Guda event that we just finished rerunning. It's the same as all the other point ladder events. Basically, beating certain free quests is going to allow you to accumulate points, and once you hit certain milestones, you're going to receive rewards. The only difference between this one and the previous Guda Guda is that you're going to be farming 2 small point ladders instead of 1 large one. So you can actually choose which point ladder to focus on between the Oda and the Shinsengumi. Each of these 2 unique factions is going to have a completely different set of free quests, and completing those is going to earn points toward the respective factions. But you can freely switch between both sides to earn points on both ladders. You are not tied to one side, so you should be farming both ladders simultaneously. The reason why you want to switch sides constantly is because each set has different rewards. With the Oda, you can earn ascension items for Cha-Cha, 3 copies of Wolves of Mibu, some craft essence experience, 2 tickets, 5 gold, silver, and bronze apples, hearts, lanugos, mana prisms, and QP. If you're working for the Shinsengumi, you can earn the fans, you can trade in for extra copies of Cha-Cha to level up her Noble Phantasm, more craft essence experience, 3 more copies of Wolves of Mibu, 2 more tickets, 5 more gold, silver, and bronze apples, as well as bloodstone tiers, gallstones, friend points, and QP. Another thing to note about this is between the 2 different point ladders, you can get all copies of Wolves of Mibu. You actually end up with 6. So again, no need to farm for craft essences. You can limit break this craft essence just from farming points in the event. If you plan on completing both ladders, they each require 1 million points, so you need to farm 2 million points in total, 1 million for Oda and 1 million for the Shinsengumi. So now that we understand the basic structure of the event, let's move on to the story. The first thing I want to note about the story and the event as a whole is that there are going to be several bonus servants that have bonus attack power during this event. Those servants are Okita, Nobunaga, Hijikata, and Cha-Cha, Emiya, Tesla, Edison, MHX, and MHX Alter, Helena, Ku, Medusa, Media, and Blackbeard. All of them are going to have varying levels of power increase, so if you have any of these servants, they're going to be much stronger during this event, and they can easily help you clear story or free quests. That said, the main story is very short, only about 8 chapters, but it is split across multiple days and time-locked, so you can't complete it all in one day. The way the event works is the main story takes place over the course of 3 rounds of battles between the Shinsengumi and Oda forces. Each round has different free quests available to farm, and after each round is complete, a new story chapter unlocks. Rounds 1 and 2 last for 24 hours, aka round 1 is going to last the first day of the event, round 2 is going to last the second day of the event. Round 3 lasts for a few days, and then there is a final epilogue and conclusion to the story, which is going to last the rest of the event. Story quests themselves are easy, completely beatable by new players just using the guest servants or borrowing a friend's berserker. If you are able to clear Septum, then this should be a breeze for you. I do recommend probably bringing a Berserker to the fights like Kyohime or Lu Bu, because a lot of the enemies are mixed classes and there's even a ruler enemy. But it's nothing too over the top. The main thing about the story is that beating it is going to allow you to unlock Cha-Cha. That happens once you beat all the story quests. In addition to that, if you do plan on fully ascending and leveling Cha-Cha, make sure you do both point ladders, because the Oda ladder is going to contain her ascension materials, while the Shinsen Gumi point ladder is going to have the extra copies that you can purchase from the shop to increase her Noble Phantasm. So very straightforward there, let's actually talk about how you should go about farming the event. There are several ways you're going to want to farm this event. You're going to want to farm it for ascension materials, you're going to want to farm the currency for the shop, and you're going to want to farm for points. But first, let's talk about farming for the shop currency. As I mentioned earlier, there is no need to farm for the event craft essence drops, because you can buy all 5 Sun Castle craft essences from the shop, and you can get all 5 Wolves of Mibu from the point ladder, so don't worry about craft essence drops. And to reiterate, the event is split into 3 rounds and an epilogue. The first 2 rounds are 24 hours long, the third round is several days long, and then the epilogue is about a week. Each round has a set of 8 free quests, 4 for each faction, so 4 for Oda and 4 for the Shinsen Gumi. The epilogue has 13 free quests. So there are actually a huge amount of free quests to beat in this event, but don't be overwhelmed, because only a handful of them actually matter for farming. For the first week of the event, aka rounds 1, 2, and 3, you have very bad drop rates for shop currency, and you cannot optimally farm at all. Do not spend any apples trying to farm the first week of the event for shop currency or points. Just use your natural AP. I can't stress that enough, because the drop rates in the epilogue are so much better. For the first week of the event, just focus on getting points, completing each free quest, and casually farming for ascension materials. Your priority should be to buy the shopcraft essence immediately, all 5 copies, but do not limit break it. Keep all 5 copies separate until the end of the event. Also, you should be rolling the friend point gacha to get that 3-star event craft essence, which is going to make farming a lot easier later on. For the first 3 rounds, all you need to do is farm the 40 AP recommended level 80 free quest. You can choose between farming the Oda or the Shinsen Gumi side, depending on which quest has the ascension materials you need, or which side you need to farm points for. But you really shouldn't be farming anything other than that 40 AP recommended level 80 free quest for the first week. For the second week of the event, the epilogue, the free quests drop a lot more currency, and this is when you can start optimally farming for clearing the shop. The bronze coins are going to be farmed at the 40 AP level 60 quest, the gold dust is going to be farmed at the 40 AP level 80 quest, and the koban is going to be farmed at the 40 AP level 90 quest. Again, the drop rates between the Oda and Shinsen Gumi side are about the same. Just farm whichever side you need the points for, whichever is easier for you to farm, or whichever side has the ascension materials you need. All that matters is that you're farming the 40 AP level 60 for the bronze coins, the level 80 for the gold dust, and the level 90 for the kabans. It doesn't matter which side you're farming for. The other major thing to farm aside from shop currency is points. Point farming will occur naturally as you play through the event, and you shouldn't focus on it until you finish clearing out everything you need from the shop and you're in the epilogue. After each round, whatever side has accumulated the most points across the whole server is going to win that round, and every player in the server is going to be rewarded with extra points toward that faction, between 50,000 and 150,000 depending on the round, so you're also going to just get a lot of free points. It's not very hard to accumulate them. Just make sure you do all of the free quests at least once so that you can earn points for both sides and you don't just ignore one side and do the other. Just like with the shop currency, in the first 3 rounds of the event, there isn't any place to farm points efficiently. You just farm the hardest difficulty free quest that's available to you, and it'll give you the most points. Once the epilogue comes out in week 2, then you can farm the 40 AP level 90 free quest for either side to earn the most respective points. You can also farm the 40 AP westernization quest to earn points for both sides simultaneously. If you're able to do that, I do suggest doing that. It'll save you a lot of time. The choice here is yours though. You can choose to either focus on doing one side's 40 AP level 90 quest, or you can focus on farming both ladders simultaneously by doing the westernization quest. It all depends on your situation. And finally, let's talk about the ascension material farming. There's going to be a lot of ascension material farming for this event. What you should know is that because the free quests rotate every round and during the epilogue, you're only going to have a certain window of time to farm certain materials. So for the first round, on the Oda side of the free quest, you'll be able to obtain Night Metals and Black Tallow, while on the Shinsengumi side, you can obtain Gears and Longunos. For the second round, the Oda side free quests are going to give you Octuplet Crystals and Lamps, while the Shinsengumi are going to give you Pages and Talons. For the third round, the Oda side is going to give you Metals and Pages, as well as Scarabs, while the Shinsengumi side you can farm Gears, Octuplet Crystals, and Reverse Dragon Scales. And then finally for the epilogue, so this is going to be where most of your time is going to go towards farming, you can get Night Metals, Octuplet Crystals, Black Tallow, Lamps, and Talons from the Nobunaga side, while the Shinsengumi side is going to give you Gears, Pages, Reverse Dragon Scales, Scarabs, and Longunos. And there's one last area I do want to touch on, and that is the challenge quest that we're going to be getting for this event. After you finish the main story and the rest of the epilogue and free quest unlock, you're going to be able to participate in the challenge quest. It's only going to cost 5 AP, but just like we had with the memorial quest, it's going to be very difficult and not for everyone. However, if you do beat it, you can win a summoning ticket. The battle is going to be against Hijikata himself, and it is going to be very similar to the Salter Memorial Quest. You're going to face Hijikata with 3 full break bars, and each time one bar breaks, he's going to have more and more HP. He's going to start at 200,000, and by the time he's at his last break bar, he's going to be at over 1 million HP. As a berserker who can crit, he can really melt nearly anyone on your team, so you need to make sure you have a heavily defensive servant that can protect your team and can provide things like invincibility, defensive buffs, or taunts. Servants like Mosh, George, Waver, Merlin, or Leonidas fit the bill perfectly. You're also going to want servants that can stunlock him to prevent him from getting off a Noble Phantasm or just doing any big damage, so I recommend bringing someone like Steno for that role. And for damage, you're really going to want to rely on someone who has an anti-male trait, like Orion, Maeve, or Uriel, because they can deplete his entire break bar in one NP chain with very little buffing. Uriel in particular is tremendous because she can do huge damage and also charm him very easily, so she can perform two roles at once. And that about wraps up everything about the event. Just make sure you're working on both ladders at the same time and go back and forth every round so that you aren't missing anything. Do not just focus on farming for one side, do both. And don't use apples until week 2 when the epilogue comes out, because until the epilogue comes out, it's not really worth farming very hard. The drop rates are just too small to make a difference. Just stick with using your natural AP for the first week, prioritize the shopcraft essence, and then just leave all of the intensive point and shop currency farming for week 2 during the epilogue. Of course, you're also going to want to prioritize getting Cha-Cha as well. And if this guide did help you, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe so that you can keep up with not just the guides, but the spotlights as well. If you want to check out those spotlights for Cha-Cha, Hijikata, Tesla, Helena, or Edison, those are all going to be linked in the description below, so take a look at that. If you aren't already, do follow us on Twitter and Twitch, where I am currently streaming Fate Extella Link, and join the party over at our Discord. And I will see you guys all in the next Servant Spotlight or Event Guide. Soberoni out. Later.